what are some of the properties of simulated annealing? Now, we already talked about two of them, this idea that as the temperature goes to zero, it's acting more and more like hill climbing, only taking steps that improve the fitness. And as T goes to infinity, it's like a random walk around the neighborhood. So wherever point where it is, it's willing to go to any of the other points in the neighborhood, and it just doesn't really pay any attention to the fitness function anymore.
So that makes sense, right? If I wanted to go with the analogy, high temperatures, like a lot of heat, which is a lot of energy, and so molecules bounce around a lot. And that kind of has the effect of flattening out the fitness function. T goes to zero, that's no energy, it's like you're frozen, molecules can't move, and so you only move to places with lower energy, or in this case, higher fitness. So that all makes sense. So how do I get from one to the other? You had in the algorithm decrease T, but do we need to decrease T quickly, slowly? What's the right way to do it?
So in practice, we want to decrease the temperature slowly because it gives the system kind of a chance to explore at the current temperature before we start to cool it out. So one way to think about it is if you consider some kind of function that we're trying to optimize, when the temperature is high, it kind of doesn't notice big valleys. It's willing to kind of wander through big valleys. As the temperature gets cooler, the valleys become boundaries and it starts to break things up into different basins of attraction, but smaller gullies it still is able to walk over. As the temperature gets even lower, those become barriers as well. And so what we really want to do is give it a chance to kind of wander to where the high-valued points are before cooling it so much that it can't now bridge the gulf between different local optima.
Okay, that makes sense. So property is it's sort of bouncing between exploration and exploitation. I buy that. So where do you end up? Where do you end up?
Well, if we're lucky, we end up at the global optimum. Yay.
Is there anything, you know, we could say? We could characterize how often we end up there? Or are we going to have to do randomized restarts and do simulated annealing a million times?
So we're not going to be able to go through the argument for exactly why this is true, but there is a remarkable fact about simulated annealing that is worth mentioning. That the probability of ending at any given point X in the space is actually e to the fitness of X divided by the temperature and then normalized, because this is a probability distribution over the input space. So this is pretty remarkable, right? So this is saying that it's most likely to be in the places that have high fitness, right? Because those are where it's going to have the highest probability of being. And you can see now what the relationship with the temperature is here too, that as we bring the temperature down, this is going to act more like a max. It's going to put all the probability mass on the actual X star, the optimum. And as the temperature is higher, it's going to smooth things out and it'll, you know, be randomly all over the place. So that's why it's really important that we eventually get down to a very low temperature. But if we get there too quickly, then it can be stuck, right? Because it's spending, time proportional to the fitness. So it is spending time ending up at points that are not the optimum if they're, say, close to the optimum.
Okay. So, you know, I actually, now that you spell that out, I actually recognize this distribution. It has a name. It's called the Boltzmann distribution.
That's exactly right. And if there's people listening that have a physics background, they're going to probably be poking their eyes out because it's the case that we're using a number of physics concepts, but we don't quite use the same notation and we don't quite do things exactly the way that a physicist would. So there's definitely a relationship. And the Boltzmann distribution is used quite a bit in the physics community. But it may not be exactly like that, so don't try not to panic.
Yeah, it's more like an analogy, like so much of life. It's a simulated Boltzmann distribution.
It's like a simile.